Samia here, wedding and portrait photographer. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to be giving you three ways you can make passive income as a photography business owner. So the first and easiest way is actually to go about selling prints of your work. So when a client books, I'm actually guaranteeing just the digital files. And then if you're using something like PixieSet, it's super easy to go in and turn on a PixieSet store, choose the supplier you want to work with, choose your pricing, and a company like PixieSet will handle the printing and delivery. So if you're a wedding photographer, another way to do this really easily is what I've done before is take an iPad to a wedding and put a little sign up that says, if you want the wedding photos, feel free to leave your email on this iPad. And then once I get all those emails, I will send the wedding gallery, of course, with permission from the couple, to everyone on the email list with a coupon code to purchase prints of they can buy their own prints of the wedding couple, they can mail them to themselves or to the wedding couple. And then you can generate a lot of sales that way. And then also you can add those people to your email list. So the second thing you can do is just start selling albums, especially if you're a wedding photographer. So I used to include albums in my wedding photography collections, and it ended up being kind of a mess because most clients would forget that they purchased an album or would be slow to design the album because they aren't that excited about it because they bought it a year ago. So I found the most success with albums in pitching the sale after the wedding has already happened. Now I'm going to show you some tricks on selling albums. Okay guys, so the first thing you want to do is make a page on your website for albums. So this is my website. If I click on weddings and I go to albums, right here, this is a YouTube video and I made my website through Show It, and I have other videos here on Show It. I made this video myself. It was super easy to make. Just put the camera on a tripod and flip through your sample album, and I edited it in iMovie. It was really, really easy. Just keep flipping through, and then what I did was I took different shots with different angles of the album just sitting on a tripod, super simple to make. And then I talk about the album a little bit right here, and then if you go down, I give the different three different most common pricing options for albums. And then this part is important. This is a contact form I made through HoneyBook, just like the other contact forms on my website, and I'm calling it the album information request. So here they can enter their information. Like that contact form, I made it in HoneyBook. So I went to tools, templates, contact forms, and I just made this contact form called album inquiry. And then I embedded it into the website. So here you'll say name, phone number, email, wedding date, anything you'd like to add. And then what you'll find here too is this is called in settings. I'm assigning the project type to album, which is what allows me to automatically respond when someone fills this out. So if I go back into tools, workflows, I'm gonna come down here and it's 2021 album auto brochure and design. So this is my workflow set up for selling albums. So when someone inquires, I'm automatically going to send this brochure that I made that has all the pricing. And then once they pick out which one they want, once they pick out which album they want, I have to send them a proposal and an invoice, which it has to be done manually. You can't automatically do that in HoneyBook. But I created a task for myself so that I remember. And then here's the design process all right here. So make sure you have a workflow in place for handling this, because it can get kind of chaotic and out of control if you don't have a workflow in place. And then the third thing you can do is to get into the education space. So like me, making YouTube videos, you can start making a YouTube channel, start generating an audience, start to sell courses, digital products, presets, things like that. There is a huge opportunity for passive income in the education space. I think a lot of beginner photographers assume that educators in our industry need to have made it 10 years in or are super, super successful. But the reality is, and I've said this in other videos, I actually learn the most from photographers who are only 10% ahead of me, because the market is changing so often and so fast that I actually personally benefit more from people who are just a little bit ahead. So with that being said, it doesn't take much for you to have input, and you always have a voice to be able to teach photography and teach things that you have learned as you learn them. So let me know in the comments if you're going to try any of these three things I mentioned, or you're already doing them. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe, because I come out with two new videos here every single week for photography business owners, and you don't want to miss the next video.